I've got a ace 51 in for a screen change. Well, potentially a screen change. Maybe it might not be. And the reason why that is because the screen works perfectly fine. So LCD works, it comes up, but we've got no touch. So this one could be a ribbon, could be the PCB board underneath, if the LCD connects to that PCB board underneath. Or it could be a screen itself, so I don't know. We're gonna find out once this fan's open. And again, I've already heated up the phone, that's why I can get into the phone so easily. Normally it's not this easy to get into the back cover for Samsung when it's cold, or at least room temperature anyway. Once you warm it up, heat it up, the adhesive becomes somewhat soft. So at least we can remove it in one piece. That came off quite nicely. Reseat this antenna. Back in place. So, I mean, immediately looking at the phone anyway, I can't see any obvious signs of water damage. But we're gonna find out as soon as it's open. Okay. Oh, we do have water damage. Interesting. Yes, we absolutely do have liquid damage, so this one may not even be a screen change. This one might just be a PCB and a ribbon change. It may not even be that. If we can clean it up, touch it up, I couldn't even get rid of that, to be fair. I happen to have the pots for this in stock anyway. In any case, I do have a charging port, and I do have the actual ribbon. I'm sure I do. But let's see, let's give this a clean and see what happens. I'm going to look at it under the microscope, see how it looks over the scope. Surprisingly,
Plus a viewing device, which is a pro. It's a good thing, it is. Save the cost for some money, which is always a good thing. Okay, one thing looking a bit suspect. Looks quite corroded. Looks disconnected even. I think we'll get away with cleaning up, looking at the corrosion and restoring it. I mean, it's connected, it's definitely connected. But it looks like it's connected by a thread, so I need to probably put a solder back to the top of this one. Okay. Also, you can put on the two bags as well. And you can tell the side is in the area we've got some of the corrosion on our flex. That's definitely too much. I'm sure I can save it. Again, we are all about recycling, guys. I absolutely can. Just replace this ribbon. I've even got replacement in stock, but I really do like to reuse, recycle as much as possible, because by me trying to look, I'm not trying to save money here. I genuinely am. The part itself cost £2-3, so the part will cost a lot. But I know if I can save that part, it's just one less thing that's going to get wasted. And if I repair it, it'll be with proper soldering wires, it'll be jumping properly, it'll be coiled properly. It's not going to cause any future issues. If that is the case, I'd like to be able to save it. Obviously, if I try and I can't, fine, I will replace it. I'd like to have tried before I start throwing things away. Okay, so that looks good. Unfortunately, I can't show you guys what I'm doing here.
I still haven't got that move.
I really need to get that move. That didn't show up. Excuse me. Okay. Okay, unfortunately, touch still doesn't work. Do you know what? Maybe I need to reboot it. Let's see. Maybe a reboot solves it. Oh yeah, yes it did. Brilliant. Brilliant. Okay. I really wish I could show you guys what's happened. Here, I'm gonna try. Let's see. Okay, so that's the kind of soldering I've done there. Well, the script of corrosion. Script of corrosion soldered it back in place. So that's that. You can see off. You can just about see off. So it's solid there also. So that was basically the point of damage. So that's it for this one. Yes, I'm gonna put UV coat on top and get back to the run and give the customer some good news. We've saved the customer screen. Thank you guys for watching.